Hello students, now I am going to continue about experimental method. Experimental method is a method in psychology or research psychology which mainly studies about the human behaviors in a controlled setting or laboratory setting. Experimental psychology or experimental method mainly studies the behavior of an individual, that is based on cause and effect relationship. It may study about antecedent, consequence and behavior. Here, in experimental method, there are well-developed methods or psychological standardized techniques used to study the behaviors. There may be psychological tests or test patterns. Here, in experimental psychology, experimenter should be an expert to conduct the experiment. He conducts the experiment on a particular person, and the person who takes the experiment is called subject. Here, before conducting the experiment, the experimenter has to take certain precautionary methods so that he can control the other intervening variables or extraneous variables. To conduct any experiment, one has to have a particular independent variable and dependent variable. What do we mean by independent variable? Any variable which is manipulated by the experimenter is called independent variable. And any variable which is elicited as a result of the introduction of independent variable is called dependent variable. Let me give you one example about independent variable and dependent variable. Say, for example, smoking cigarette causes cancer. Smoking is independent variable and cancer is the dependent variable. Like that, say for example, let me give you another psychological example. Say for example, scolding creates emotional tension in a person. So scolding is independent variable and emotional tension or outburst is an emotional tension is dependent variable. In order to conduct any experiment, the experimenter must concentrate not only on independent and dependent variables but also extraneous variables. Extraneous variables are those variables which may intrude in between the conduction of experiment. Let me give you another example related to psychology, that is scolding a child causes emotional tension in it. Here scolding is the independent variable and emotional tension is the dependent variable. Here in experimental psychology, in order to conduct the experiment, we require matched groups. Matched group means what? Matched group refers to a group which is a balanced group with regard to the gender or educational status, age group, caste, creed, religion or geographical area. Those groups which are equal in all the aspects, they are considered as matched group. If you have to study any issue, psychological variable on any person or a group of people, then you require a matched group. Then in experimental psychology, we come across two types of groups. They are called controlled group and experimental groups. What do we mean by controlled group? Controlled group is the group to which there is no introduction of any independent variable. That is only kept for comparison purpose and no treatment is given. That is called controlled group. Whereas experimental group is the group which is subjected to independent variable. The treatment of independent variable is given to experimental group and it is studied, the effect is studied in experimental group. Then we are going to compare the result output, that is in terms of behavior, with the controlled group. While conducting the experiment, one should be very careful regarding the extraneous variables. Because unexpectedly, some extraneous variables or variables that may intervene and they may hinder the results in experiments. Say for example, when you are conducting an experiment in a controlled setting, if any loud sound comes, then there will be distraction. So loud sound is a distractor or extraneous variable. So like this, there may be some other extraneous variables which come while conducting the experiment. Maybe orgasmic variables also come into action that may hinder the results of the experiment. But however, we can see that experimental method is one of the best method in psychological research. With the help of experimental research, we can get accurate results, and it is repeatable also. You can repeat the experiment again and again, and you can get the same result in behavioral science. That is the major advantage of experimental method. Whereas there are some demerits of this method, but it is very few. Then what are all the demerits? First one is, there is difficulty in getting the matched group, one thing. And human ethics comes into picture, then human ethics comes into picture when we think about conducting experiments. All the experiments cannot be conducted on human beings. And another one is, there are chances of intervening variables that may affect the results or the reliability of experiment. Thank you.